Hello, all you beautiful people out there. What is going on? This is your friend Britic coming at you fast with some Smite gameplay. What? Today, we're going to be talking about The Void Left by Paragon and why Smite does not fill it. At least personally for me, I know a lot of people in my comment section have agreed with me on this one, that they tried Smite and they couldn't get into it. Other people have tried Smite and they've liked it even more than Paragon, and that's totally fine, and I will explain the reason as to why in this video, but I'll also try to pinpoint three factors as to why Smite can't entertain me in the same way that Paragon did. And because I've been analyzing this quite a bit, I was wondering, like, I tried to play some more Smite, like, I went back to it after the update and everything, and I played some more, but I couldn't get into it, man. I couldn't really get into it, you know, like, it didn't hook me, it didn't grasp me, it didn't make, like, it's a fun game, it's a good game, like, do not be fooled, okay? As a MOBA, Smite is a really, really good game, okay? And where this video is not about versing the two together, because obviously, and quite literally, one of them has already won, okay? The other one doesn't exist anymore. But what I want to talk about is why Smite doesn't scratch that Paragon itch. Like, why you just can't go from Smite to Paragon, and some of you might be able to, and I will also explain the reason why you can, and while others can't. So, anyway, let's get into the first thing. So, let's just start off with that. So, why can people get into Smite and they can't get, and then others can't get into Smite? So, if you went from Paragon and you went to Smite, and you enjoyed Smite way more than you did Paragon, that means that you are a big fan of MOBAs. That you liked playing Paragon because it was a MOBA, right? You liked playing Paragon because it was really pretty, and it was a third-person action MOBA that had those mechanics in it. Smite has way better MOBA mechanics than Paragon did. All right, let's be honest. Let's not beat around the bush here, okay? Paragon had a lot of problems, especially with its item system. It was lacking identity with its item system. Whereas Smite's item system, it's pretty typical MOBA, right? It's pretty straightforward. You've seen it everywhere. All the items are there for you. And once you learn some builds, you realize that, hey, okay, I can get the general gist of this. Once you know how to build certain heroes in a certain way, okay, I know this hero needs mostly damage and crit chance. All right, I know this person's a tank, so they need health and armor. And with yada, 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 all the above, Smite executes better on that. Plus, Smite is just more balanced, right? Smite has been around for a while, and Smite is really balanced. They've had more time to get their shit down, and in that sense, it makes the experience much better. Now, let's talk about three reasons as to why it doesn't scratch that itch. Will I be able to get into Smite in the future? Maybe, perhaps, but it's not on my radar, so to speak. Like, it's not one of the games that will take over my life like Paragon did. And that's really what I'm trying to say here, is that's why it doesn't scratch that itch in the same way, no matter how good you are as Thor against silvers and golds. So anyway, let's go over the first point here that I want to cover, and that's the roster. So Smite has a very, very large roster of, and for those of you who don't know what Smite is, all the characters are basically gods from different mythologies. You have Chinese, you have the Greek gods, you have the Norse gods, so it's pretty cool, right? In that sense, pretty cool, and you can have a very diverse and large roster, which is great. But because these gods already exist in mythology, they're not video game characters, they're actually, like, you know, real, it's hard to say real gods, because it's like all mythology, it's all supposed to be myth, but they're already based on something that we already know about. Like, it's based on something that you are familiar with, and in that case, you can get creative with it, but other than that, you already know what you're looking at. You already know you're looking at Thor. I don't know why I had that New York accent real quick. You already know you're looking at Thor, right? You already know you're looking at Odin. You know you're looking at Hellas or whatever. Like, you know who you're looking at. You know what they're about. Whereas Paragon's roster, these characters were unique. They were original. Maybe their movesets weren't all that original in some places, but for the most part, in the very beginning at least, the Paragon characters were very, very interesting, and they had their own specific character to them. Like, you can just look at Twin Blast, and you could already tell, after playing two games with him, just the way his animations were, just the way he acted, just the little snippets of lore that we had, and then his emotes, you could tell he was a tool. He was a total and utmost tool. He was probably the guy who put on way too much axe in high school, right? That was fucking Twin Blast, right? So you already knew that's who he was. That was his character, but you didn't know that previously. You knew that because you could just tell that's what kind of dude he was. It felt like every character was really robust, and they were mysterious as well, because we didn't have all that lore yet. And that's what made it so fun. That's what made it so interesting, because once you got a hold of a character's playstyle and they became your main, you just fell in love with them. You fell in love with everything about them from just 0 to 100 real quick, right? You fell in love with not just their moves or how good they are or whatever, but you fell in love with how they handle and how they feel and the stories that they tell and the stories that they had. Maybe I'm taking too deep of an analysis in this shit, okay, because I like being very detailed and whatnot, but that's how I felt. Like, with Grux, Grux was my favorite. I loved Grux. Like, I wanted to know more about his tribe. I wanted to know more about what was going on with his grandma, if she was ever gonna be like a skin or something, you know, like that would have been so freaking awesome. And just the way it interacted with that world was just really great. I mean, Iggy and Scorch, right? Like, you take that pair right there, that character, that playable character duo, and oh my god, so much fun, so crazy, so insane, and just fun in general. So I feel like Paragon's roster had like this unique just character to the characters. Like Kalari, you could tell she was so serious, she was a badass, she had this crazy past and these hidden secrets, and I don't know, man, the characters were just so interesting to me. I might be the only one on that, but I think they are a little bit more interesting than that. I mean, don't get me wrong, like, gods are fucking sick too. Like, oh yeah, to be able to shoot fire and flame arrows, or, you know, you have a chimera running around, this fucking dog right here just killing shit, like, that's pretty cool. But I mean, I already knew about it, you know, like, I've seen it before, kind of, whereas, I don't know, Paragon's characters, again, felt really unique. That was really drawn out. I didn't expect to spend so much time on that one. Second one was the verticality in the game, plus the aesthetic, like, the environment. It created a beautiful environment and breathtaking feeling when you combined the two and contrasted the two things together. When you had the beautiful landscape and environment all around you, and then you had just the mayhem and the combat happening everywhere, and it was all crazy, and just the splashback between those two things together was so mesmerizing to me. Like, when I watched gameplay, even, I felt like so hooked to it. It was just so fascinating, so great, not just because it was super pretty, but because you understood what was going on, you understood the surroundings. Like, you could tell, oh, this dude is about to get cornered, or this dude's about to get trapped, or this person jumped up here and cornered them around. And I feel like Paragon did that better than any other MOBA, where you could really just understand what the hell was going on just by looking at the gameplay, because again, it was really good. And it was not as a MOBA per se, but as an action fast-paced game, it was really entertaining to watch and beautiful to just look at. And then when you were playing it, you were sometimes struck by the beauty, especially in Legacy, man. Like, the beautiful canopy on the jungle was just so, like, sometimes I would just look up while I was running just to see how pretty it was. And then you have that, and you compare and contrast it with the mayhem that was going on. You would fight in the team fights, and I don't know, there's just a special feeling about it, and it's really hard to describe, but I am kind of reaching here for some special, like, what is the real reason, like, why, like, getting all philosophical in this shit, you feel me, like, why do I love Paragon so much, and why couldn't Smite deliver the same thing, like, what was the difference here, and that's why I'm really digging deep with these. And the third thing is, like we've been over time and time again, Paragon is an action MOBA. It was very unique in that sense. It felt very unique, right? Like I said in a video earlier, I love Paragon because it was Paragon, not because it was a MOBA. The fast-paced action was unparalleled and will still be unparalleled until something else like it comes out. Because Smite, it's great, right? Smite, it's fast, cool, but it's not as fast. It's a MOBA, and it does a job of MOBAs well. But I feel like Paragon was almost in its own category in that sense, where it was a third-person action game walking in the pants of a MOBA, right? Walking in the shoes of a MOBA. That's what that was. That's what it felt like, which is why it was so damn fun to me. Because Smite is not an action game, it is a MOBA. Like, yeah, you have to aim, and you have to press some buttons to do some moves, but it's too much of a MOBA to feel like the way Paragon felt. I hope that makes sense. I don't know any other way to just really describe that, but I think people kind of understanding what I mean by that. So really, those are three really, I think, the most important points for me, at least. I'm sure some people can agree as to why it just felt that way, as to why Paragon just seemed more enjoyable than Smite. But don't get me wrong, like, I don't want to have a bunch of Smite fanboys in here saying that, oh, you fucking suck. I love Smite. I think Smite is a great game. I'm just saying that it does not fill that Paragon void. It does not do what Paragon did for me. And I just gave my reasons as to why I think so. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed. As always, make sure you have a wonderful day.